Hello, everyone. Welcome to Gore Mountain. It is an overcast day. We have got the women's and men's free ski slopestyle finals coming up. It is a stunning course that has been put together by Arena Snowparks. It is in perfect condition. We have got three rail features at the top, two jumps at the bottom. If you're watching slopestyle for the first time, wondering how it's scored, well, it is a two-run contest, and it is the best run to count that we take forward to the final standing. As you can see, the weather conditions, it is overcast. It's not the beautiful day that we had yesterday and on Monday. 0 degrees. The snow's holding up pretty well, though. The course is in perfect condition. Visibility is good. Let's get a look at the women's start list. Olivia Burke from Great Britain will be first to go. Una Koga, the top qualifier, last. First skier getting ready to drop in, Olivia Burke, 20-year-old from the University of Aberdeen. So Burke on the way. She's got her parents here watching into the first rail. On that down rail, nice and clean. That's a solid start for Burke. That sort of dish one, she could possibly 270 off of that one. So there's a little more potentially to come on the second run. The jumps are key. She's got through the rails cleanly. Left 360 into the bottom jump. This is where she's been going, 720. She's going to go for it again. Just goes for another left three. So getting something to feet on the first run. And that is a solid start. She's smiling. That is the important thing. She's got that run on the board, and what that'll do is it'll give her that confidence going into the second run. It was the left three. What she has to do to boost the score on the second run, ideally you want to be spinning different directions, but she's got it on the board, and that is key. In this contest, you just never know what the other skiers are going to do, so having something on the board is so helpful. She gets 63.75. Thea Fenwick, also from Great Britain, out of Staffordshire University, 21 years old. She's had great support from Staffordshire University in helping her get here. Family are here as well. And Thea grew up skiing all disciplines. She's done a bit of moguls, ski cross, alpine as well. She's charging in. 270 out of that rail. It's a fast-charging run from Thea Fenwick. That is how she skis, dropping switch into the first of the kickers. Switch 180. Gets the grab as well, setting up for the final jump. She puts the 720 down. Solid start from Thea Fenwick. It's been until yesterday, sometimes since she'd actually landed a throw in a seven. She just felt confident yesterday in the run. And the switch 180 was good. And the final 720, she's not grabbing. That pulls the score down a little. Do really need to be grabbing the skis if you want to get a big score. But it's in, it's 74. So she sits in first place right now. Three to go on run one in the women's finals. Michelle Ragath from Switzerland next to go. Attends the Swiss Federal Institute of Sport. 19 years old. She's had two World Cup starts. Actually finished 17th in the Dubai World Cup at the start of the season. She is boosting through the rails here. A lot of speed into the first jump. She was the second qualified at 540. Set right five with the tail grab. Comes in switch to the final jump. Switch five, and that is solid from Ragath from Switzerland. No major mistakes in the run. That should go into top spot. We'll see on the replay. The rail game was a step up from what we've seen from other skiers, gapping onto the rail as well. Here she goes into the 540 with the tail grab. She lands switch and then hits the next jump, the final jump. Switch as well, so Ragath is going to get a serious score on the board. gets the safety grab. That's when you reach down, your right or left hand down under the right or left boot. She's managed that well. So 92-5. Ragath into top spot. She smiles, a little nod. It is going to plan for the Swiss skier. One to go and run one. For the women, it is Yuna Koga out of Waseda University in Tokyo. Japanese skier, the top qualifier, 20 years old. She has got some serious skills. Back 270 onto the down rail. 270 out of that one now. Into this up rail, the cannon rail, now setting up switch. Switch into the first of the jumps. Switch five, oh no! Oh, that is a shame. She is down on the first run. See it again. She's reaching for the grab. Just goes a little bigger than she's expecting. Doesn't look as stable in the air. The weight's a little back. The hips a little back. These landings are steep, and she's just not able to recover. So Yuna Koga from Japan gets 24.5. Puts her in fifth place. So after run one for the women, we'll get a look at the standings. It's Michelle Ragath of Switzerland leading, Fenwick of Great Britain in second, Olivia Burke of Great Britain in third. Koga, of course, that big mistake. So this one is not over. So we get ready now for the second and final run for the women.
Thank you.
That's it.
Create a great atmosphere. Now Olivia Burke from the University of Aberdeen. Her brother and sister Luke and Melissa are watching. Simon will be watching as well. She skied out of the Bears Den Ski Club as well in northern Glasgow. Great dry slope. Developed a lot of quality skiers. So she's going for a pretty similar rail section. Now Olivia Burke was in third place. Just goes for the 360. It comes up a little short. Is she going 720 here? Left seven just squeezes it round. She's got it done in finals. And you can see how happy she is. That is great to see. Getting that 720 done. That's what she wanted. She's worked really hard these last few days to really get dialed into the course, and here she goes into the seven. She just gets it round, but she's gone for it. That is important. That is the key thing, and she's trying to improve on a 63.75. Can she improve the score? She can. Goes up to a 70, so she moves in the right direction. Stays in third place. Michelle Ragath next to go. She's the current leader, 92.25. She's guaranteed a gold or silver here. But because Yuna Koga is still to come, Ragath is not going to just take it easy. She is charging. Pretzel off of the rail, now into the jumps. Ragath has put on a great display. Oh, she's not at the speed there, just having to air it out. So she's not going to improve on the first run score. Big 360 there. So 92.25 is what she is going to carry forward. It'll be first or second, gold or silver for Ragath. But the top qualifier, Yuna Koga, is still to come. And we know how good a skier she is. Sure, she gets a 59.75, does Ragath, but 92.25 leads. The 20-year-old has competed at a high level at the Youth Olympics. She won a FIS contest in 2019, a Copper Mountain, beating a lot of the American skiers. Super clean on the rails. This is going to plan for Yuna Koga. Switch 540, the final jump now for Yuna Koga. She lands it, she's going to be on the podium. She does. Left nine, she sticks it. Super clean. That's going to push Burke off the podium. and Yuna Koga with a lot of pressure to deal with there. Delivered under pressure, but where is she going to go? Is it better than the 92-25 for the current leader from Switzerland, Michelle Ragath? It's here on this second jump. Stomps the 900. Yuna Koga, is she going into top spot? Do the judges like it enough? We're waiting, looking at this again. I think it might just go into top spot. We are going to find out any moment. Will it be gold for Japan here at the Fizu World University Games? They've not seen the scores yet. Now they see 94-75. Yuna Koga does it on the final run. She takes the gold medal. A stunning performance right when it mattered. Michelle Ragath picks up the silver, and Thea Fenwick from Great Britain picks up such a well-deserved bronze medal. Yuna Koga and Michelle Ragath just a cut above the rest of the field, and what a battle we had between those two, all coming down to the final run. So the Japanese team celebrate a gold medal here, but we move quickly on to run number one for the men. 10 men through to finals. Top three from qualifying are the last three skiers to go. Manatsu Sato from the Waseda University in Tokyo, 19 years old. First in big air at the Japanese nationals. Japan has some serious talent in this sport. He was fourth in the slopestyle, 20th in the NORAM at last season. He has been competing outside of Japan, comes in switch to the second rail. Switch 450 onto that rail. Technical. 630 out of the rail into the first jump. He drops the right side 900, setting in to the final jump. Coming in switch. Switch 12. So we have to see that one again. To my eye, that was a switch 12 on the bottom jump, the biggest spin that we've seen. There's the 1260 with the mute grab. And this is going to be a really healthy score for the Japanese skier. 87-25. And he has set the benchmark for the rest of the field. Next up from Thailand, Paul Vuitton out of Grenoble. Alps University, did compete in 2019 in Krasnoyarsk. World University Games, he was 19th there. Best World Cup result of 13th. That came in Milan in 2017 in big air. So he'll have his eyes on that big air contest in a couple of days. 450 out now into the jumps. He's looking for a bit of speed here. He's gone big. Double misty on that first jump. Switch into the second jump. Switch 10, and he just squeezes it round. Impressive from Vuitton from Thailand. A switch 10 on the final jump from the skier from Thailand. Score in, it's 92 into top spot. That is going to take some beating. Julius Forder from Austria, another skier out of the University of Innsbruck. 22 years old, competed on the World Cup Tour in Copper Mountain in December. That was in big air. Little loose on the first rails, but he's charging in with a lot of speed. Goes for that same sort of misty off of the last rail. Switch into the first jump. Switch 9. Now final jump for Julius Forer from Austria. Big left, 12.60. So that was solid from the man that qualified in second place. This Misty with the safety grab is going to pick up some healthy points as well. Superb landing. See him into this one. Switch 900. It sets him up forwards for the final jump. Score coming in now for the Austrian. Going to hit the podium, but where? He's in third. 85. Third place for Forer for Austria. One to go. And it is the top qualifier. Right, Kasamura from Japan, 18 years old, out of Taito Bunkai University. 5 NORAM starts. Best of 15th in 2022. So 270 on to the first rail. He's keeping it all under control. Nice 450 out. Pretzel 450 out, actually. So 450 onto that one now, into the final, the first of the jumps. Lovely floating right 900 into the final jump. Switch 1260. So the jumps for me, clean, smooth, great progression. He kept it all under control. Jump number one here. Does he get locked on the grab? He does. He holds the grab pretty well throughout the trick. Stomps the landing on the 900. Just manages the speed coming in, sets up for a switch, 1260 with the mute grab. Judges are going to like this, they really are, because the execution was so high. And he had the difficulty in there, the runs, it just looked good from top to bottom. Smooth, clean, well executed, and into first place. Right, Kasamura leads for Japan. So run one comes to a close here at Gore Mountain at Lake Placid 2023, the Fiji World University Games. That is how things look in the men's standings. Manatsu Sato, currently in the bronze medal position, 87.25 for the 19-year-old. So he's got what is potentially a medal-winning score, but with the likes of Julius Forer, Noah Shallett, Jay Hebblethwaite all behind him, Sato is going to want to improve. Japan has so much talent in free skiing and snowboarding. And you can see that with what we've seen already today with Unikoga. And Sato into the jumps, which is what he prefers. Right 900. Now coming in switch, coming in backwards to the final jump. He's not quite got the amplitude. Switch 10 though. And it was really low. Is he pumped up or is he angry? I can't tell. I think he's pretty happy with that one. He should be. He's blocked on the mute grab on the switch 10. Did he go switch 14? Yeah, he got that switch 14 and missed it. My apologies on the first run. Well, this could really push his score. We've still not got the score in yet. Sato with that 14 moves into second, 93.5. And that puts Japan in first and second. Next up, Jakob Gessner from Germany out of Munich. A couple of World Cup starts. Now on his first run, he's got a 65.75. That puts him in eighth place. Nice work onto the rail. Yeah, that delighted the crowd. Onto the shark spin. Oh, he almost, I think his skis, his boots clattered together, but he's held on. So into this final jump, what is he setting up for? Big double 10. So Gessner in the finish area. Double bio 10. I like it from Gessner. Judges are surely going to like it. Where is he going to place? Will it be on the podium? It is 92.75. Paul Vitop from Thailand out of the Grenoble Alps University in France. He's on a 92 from the first run. Just 0.75 behind Gessner, who's in third. Bressel 270 out of that first down rail. So Vitop 19th in Krasnoyarsk. This is a very technical rail section, but it's the jumps that Vitop likes. Go for the double bio. 900, switch into the final jump. Switch 10. Switch double 10. It was a clean run. It was a nice run. Technically very good on the rails. Locked on the mute grab on the double. It's a misty, I think I called bio. The feet coming over the head. Oh, and he jumps back onto the podium. Third place, 93.25. Vitop on the podium right now, but it's not guaranteed. Julius Porter, 22-year-old from Austria, out of the University of Innsbruck.
Come on, Julius, let's go.
Gets a shout of encouragement from the coach. So this is a huge run. Can the Austrian find the improvement to change the order of things on the podium? Oh no, it's all gone. It's not gonna happen. Rai Kasamura, last skier to go on a victory lap. Now often the Japanese skiers and snowboarders don't like a victory lap. They still give us their full run. Will Kasamura do the same? He knows he's got the gold medal. Just keeping it all together nicely. Well, no victory lap. This is a full blast through the park from Rai Kasamura.
And he is going to go right nine.
Huge right nine onto the final jump. Rai Kasamura from Japan. He's going switch 14. Beautiful from Rai Kasamura.
Are you kidding me?
Switch 14 on the final hit. Didn't just want to win it, wanted to win it in style. And he has done that. 95 on the first run. He's going to improve, actually, because it was so relaxed on the rail section, so smooth. And then that casual switch 14, four full spins, done backwards as well, just to make it more challenging, more fun. There it is, 97.75. It is the highest score of the day, of course. But he already had the gold medal. A historic day for Thailand. Paul Vitop getting their first medal in skiing, in freestyle skiing. What a day for Japan. Gold and silver in the men's ski slopestyle. Gold in the women's here at Gore Mountain. Lake Placid 2023 Fizu World University Games.